comes after the stock market suffered its worst losses since the financial crisis of 2008.
Yes. Hi guys, CA Rachana Ranade here, and I welcome you all to my new lecture on futures and options. If you remember in my previous video, I had asked you whether you want a separate series on futures and options, and I received so many requests that I thought that it's high time that I should at least give an introductory lecture on futures and options. If you feel more and more interest in that, just let me know again so that I will be motivated to make another separate lecture and a series of F&O lecture series, right? As of now, many people might be just knowing, what is F&O? It's futures and options. But exactly what is F&O? Simple. It's a type of derivative, right? Now, you might be wondering, earlier, we didn't know what is F&O. Now, we don't know one more term. And what is that? Derivative. So, if you want to know derivatives, check out it in the next section. Now, let's understand exactly what do we mean by a derivative. If you want to go by theory first, theoretically or by definition, derivative is a financial instrument which derives its value from an underlying asset. And I'm sure you have understood nothing, correct? So let me explain it properly, one by one. What is it? It's a financial instrument. Shares, financial instrument. Bonds, it's a financial instrument. Similarly, derivatives is what? It's a financial instrument, okay? So like you can invest in shares, you can invest in bonds, you can invest in debentures. Similarly, you can invest in derivatives. Fair enough. So it's a financial instrument which derives its value. It derives its value means it gets its value from what? From an underlying asset. I'll give you a very simple example to start off with. Okay, visualize that you are having something like a payback card. If you have heard about it, then you will understand this in 1 second. Payback card is not a debit card. It's not a credit card. It's a card in which you just gain points. Okay, now how do you gain the points? You gain points only when you swipe your debit card or swipe your credit card. Okay, now this payback, the value of this payback or the points increase only if your debit card spends increase or your credit card spends increase. Okay, so the value of the points increases when the underlying is your debit card or credit card, the spends increase. So the payback derives its value from the underlying asset, which is a debit card or a credit card. This is a very crude way, but it's a very simple way of explaining what is a derivative. I'll give you practical examples now. For example, there is a derivative of, let's say, a stock derivative like Reliance Industries derivative. Okay. If I'm saying that it's a future of Reliance Industry, okay, the future of Reliance Industry value will increase only when the underlying, which is the stock of Reliance Industries, increases. So one more time, if the value of stock of Reliance Industries increases, automatically the derivative of Reliance Industries value will also increase. Number one. Number two example, let me give you an example of a commodity derivative. What could be a commodity? Simple example can be wheat. I have bought a wheat derivative. When will the value of wheat derivative increase? It will increase only when the value of the underlying asset increases. What is the underlying asset? It's wheat. If wheat value increases, the derivative increases. If wheat value decreases, the derivative value will decrease. Right? One more example. I'm talking about currency derivatives, let us say. And I'm talking about US dollar derivative. When will US dollar derivative value increase? Only when the US currency becomes stronger. If US dollar increases, then automatically the US derivative will increase. Okay? So what is a derivative? One last time. It is a financial instrument which derives its value from the underlying asset. Okay? I don't think there can be any more examples. Okay, one last example actually. One last example. What could be a derivative? It could be an index derivative also. Okay? Like a Nifty derivative. Nifty derivative, the value will increase only when the underlying asset. What is the underlying asset? Nifty. If Nifty increases, Nifty derivative will increase. If Nifty goes down, Nifty derivative will also go down. Okay? And on a lighter note, I can say that you all are a derivative. Okay, and I am the underlying asset. Why? Because you are deriving knowledge from my knowledge. Okay, if I have a stronger knowledge, if I increase my knowledge, automatically your knowledge is going to increase, right? So always remember me as the derivative and the underlying concept. Now let's come to what are the types of derivatives, because I'm sure you might have heard a lot of people talking about stock market, wherein they say that we have taken a position of futures or options, but you might not have heard people saying that I bought a derivative. Okay, but now I'm sure everyone knows what's a derivative. So now it's time to understand what are the different types of derivatives. So here are the different four types of derivatives, wherein we say forwards, futures, options and swaps. These are primarily four types of derivatives. Okay, but as far as the stock market is concerned, forwards and swaps, they don't form a part of trading. Okay, so can you trade in futures? Yes. Can you trade in options? Yes. Exactly. What is the difference between futures, options? That itself is a different content of a lecture. So again, if you want to know more about exactly what's a future, what is an option, what is a call, what is a put, that itself makes a separate lecture. Let me know and I'll definitely make a separate lecture on these content as well. Now that you have understood what is a derivative, what are the different types of derivatives, only futures and options can be traded on the stock market. The whole question is that why derivatives even exist? Okay, there's an amazing thing which is there about derivatives, and for that you need to understand that derivatives are primarily used for two major things. Which are the two major things? One is for hedging and one is for speculation. Okay, if I'm talking about the simple one, first is speculation. Speculation comes from the normal English word to speculate. To speculate means I'm just trying to bet on something. Okay, don't look at it from a negative sense that finally stock market is betting and satta and all that. Betting means what? I'm trying to trying to gauge as to what will be the direction of the market. So for example, if I feel that market will go up, okay, then what am I doing? I'm speculating that market will go up. I'm thinking, I'm feeling that market will go up. Okay, am I taking this position to earn profit? Yes. Okay, if I feel that markets are going down or markets might go down, what I will do? I will do a short sale. Okay, what do we mean by short sale? In simple words, you sell first and you buy later. Okay, I'll give you a simple example on this. If you remember just at the beginning of the video, when markets were going down, I was very happy. Why was I happy? Let us understand. When market was around 9,500, I thought that there is a great chance that market will fall down. Okay, so what did I do? I sold Nifty, and now you know Nifty derivatives can be sold because underlying asset is Nifty. Okay, and what is a derivative? Nifty future or Nifty option will be the derivative. So what did I do? I sold Nifty at 9,500 level. If the market goes down and down and down, what will I do? Let's say the market goes down from 9,500 to 8,000 level. Okay, will I be happy? Yes. Why? Because I've sold at 9,500. And if the market really goes down to 8,000 level, this 1,500 gap is my profit. Because what I will do is when market goes down to 8,000 level, that is when I will buy. Check this out. Will it be one and the same? Buying at 8,000 first and selling at 9,500, case one, versus case two, selling at 9,500 first and then buying at 8,000. Finally, it's bottom to top, top to bottom. But then where's the difference? The difference is that if market is at 9,500 right now, and if I feel it will go down, that is where derivatives come into play. I can sell my position first. I can wait back. I can relax. So right now, even if market is going a little bit up and down, I have not closed the position. What do you mean by I have still not closed the position? I have sold at 9,500 and that position still exists. So I'm just praying every day. So whenever I read the newspaper and I see that market is going down, whenever news channels say market is going down, I'm like very happy, because the target is that it should go down to a good level. If it goes down, that's when I'm going to make profit. Okay. So why did I take this position? I took a position to speculate. My speculation, my thought process was that market will go down, and that is why I had entered into this position. Fair enough. Yes. This is part one, speculate. Part two, why do I take a derivative position? Is because I want to hedge my position. What do we mean by hedge? Hedge means I enter into the position to reduce my losses. Okay. So please understand again, what is the basic difference between hedging and speculation? My primary intention of speculation is to earn profit, but my primary intention of hedging is to reduce my losses. Okay. So why or how can I do that? Simple. Assume that I had bought many shares in my portfolio when market was at 11,500, was at 12,000, was at 12,400 also. So you can imagine I have bought stocks worth rupees 10 lakhs. Bolne mein kya hota hai? Okay, or 10 crores, whatever, I can say any amount, right? So I have bought stocks worth rupees 10 crores, let us say. What can happen? Because the market is going down, there's a great possibility that the value of stocks which was 10 crores is now maybe 5 crores. Okay, so I know that my value of my portfolio is going to go down. Now to reduce these losses, I want to enter into a profit position. I want to compensate for that losses. And if I want to take a position to compensate for the losses, that is where I say I enter into a derivative contract with an intention to hedge my position. Okay, so that is hedging. See, finally, how do you trade, whether you buy or whether you sell? It is going to be the same. How do you differentiate hedging and speculation? It is the intention. Okay, if your intention is to only earn profits, it's pure speculation. If your intention is to minimize your risks, minimize your losses, that's where we call it as a hedging. Okay, I have not talked about any strategy as of now. I just wanted to clarify the difference between hedging and speculation, and very important, why derivatives exist. Well, that was my attempt on how futures and options can be taught in the most simplified format. Because when I remember when I was in CA final and when this topic was introduced to us, our teacher had taught this for 3 hours continuously. When we all came outside the classroom, no one was talking to each other. Everyone had gone in a trance. And it was like we could actually feel our head going very hot. So I don't want you all to go through this. We will cover these topics part by part at our own pace. So do let me know if you would want me to talk more and more about futures and options. I hope you are enjoying my content. Do consider subscribing to my channel and hitting the bell icon as well. That's it from my side. Jai Hind. Bye-bye.